The day started with a procession through Kabale town, coupled with cultured dances. During his speech, the Kabale District Health Officer Alfred Basigensi highlighted the various strides the nation has made in midwifery.
We want also to thank the government for improving infrastructure. When you look around, from regional referral hospitals to general hospitals to health center four, at least there is an improvement in the infrastructure. We have the maternity wards where our mothers can deliver from. We have the equipment that is necessary to produce the best results.
Basigensi said there is still a lot to be desired to fully appreciate midwives.
There is burnout of our midwives, and finally they end up misbehaving, some of them, because of the workload. So it would be better if we can now change the structure to improve the workforce.
Midwives are skilled to provide up to 90%, as has been said also by the representative of the Ministry of Health, of the sexual and reproductive health care needed, making them the ideal health professionals to support women and families through this continuum of care.
Midwives were hailed for ensuring quality health services against all odds.
As members of parliament, we have made sure that at least in this financial year, we have increased the salaries of midwives and other health workers. We hope it continues going up, such that they can be motivated to do their work very well.
We also need to improve in the areas where we have weaknesses. I believe in a concept of quality improvement. So whenever there is a mistake, most times we look at it as an area of learning and make sure that we perform better the next time.
At the same function, the government was given 21 days to respond to the concerns of nurses and midwives before they announced the next course of action.
We signed a CBA called Collective Bargaining Agreement with a number of unions in the whole country, spelling out how much a nurse should earn for this financial year. And that CPA has never been respected. So we are calling upon government that within 21 days, at least respect to respond us, respond to us, how much we expect.
Because we have a lot of challenge. As you have seen, we have shortage of staff, because that initially started when we are only 2 nurses, 2 midwives. At times we don't have equipment to use. Our salary is low according to the work we do.
However, the guest of honor, Justin Kasule Lumumba, the minister in charge of general duties in the office of the prime minister, asked the health ministry to write a clear proposal indicating the challenges they need the government to address in the nurses and midwifery field.
Sometimes you people who are especially scientists, you lose out on the most important things. You talk like you are talking to those who know, and because you know, you think everybody knows. You don't take time to explain further, like you explained to us on issues when you are diagnosing. So you assume same salary scale. We should all, I don't know. What are you meaning? I don't know. Explain to me so that I get you, I become your advocate.
The International Day of the Midwife is celebrated annually on 5th May, providing the opportunity to honor the work of midwives and promote awareness of the crucial care that midwives provide to mothers and their newborns. This year marks the establishment, 100 years ago, of the International Confederation of Midwives. This report was compiled by Job Namanya in Kabale.